Hey, it's me, Destin. Welcome back to Smarter Every Day. When you think about gemstones, people typically have their favorites. I happen to think that opal is one of the most fascinating stones there is. Think about it. If you think about a diamond or a sapphire or even a ruby, it's just a colored rock. Opals are different. Opals are created by specifically stacked hydrated silica spheres that will diffract light as it enters the rock, and it'll exit as blue, green, or even red. This is fascinating. In order to create something so specific, it requires a very precise geologic condition in order for that to form. So today on Smarter Every Day, the question is simple. How do we find an opal if it has to be created under very specific conditions? The answer, quite literally, is we're going to have to travel to the other side of the world, to one of these specific places that opals are created, and find an opal prospecting expert. To find the guy, I flew to Coober Pedy Australia, which is the opal capital of the world. It looks like Mars, like straight out of Mad Max. In fact, it's where they filmed Mad Max. It's such a harsh environment that people live underground, and this sounds like a joke, but you're not supposed to walk backwards at all in the town. Seriously, someone died by falling in a mineshaft the week before I got there. I had no plan when I arrived, so I walked straight into the visitor center and asked for an opal mining expert.
I am with George.
George. Gardashi.
Gardashi?
Gardashi, a brother.
Gardashi, I'm sorry. So he came to Coober Pedy in 1969.
Yes.
And he's been mining his entire life. So today, he has agreed to take us out. We're going to go to a working mine?
We'll go to a drill for Opal with a drill. Cold drill, American drill.
Okay, we're going to go use an American drill to drill a hole, a shaft down into an opal mine.
Yeah, boy.
Right. This should be awesome. Let's go give it a shot. What does that sign say? Hold on, back up. Let me look at that sign.
That sign says shafts. It's danger.
Danger.
Don't walk backwards.
Don't walk backwards? So everywhere there is a... Everywhere there's a pile of dirt, there's a shaft into the ground. How deep would the shaft be?
This area will be 20 meters.
So everywhere I see a pile of dirt, there's a 20 meter shaft.
Yeah, definitely.
Oh my goodness. But there's also horizontal shafts at the bottom of the vertical shafts, right?
Sorry?
Aren't there also shafts that go side to side?
No, that's tunnels, not shafts.
Okay. Tunnels.
After, yes, of course. Where you live, Alabama?
Alabama.
Ah, that's why, you don't know.
So if somebody hears that you've struck opal, they will come at midnight and try to steal your opal.
No. That's another thing. But they try to peg the claims even nighttime.
What's that word you're using? Peck?
To pegged. Put the pegs down.
Peg.
Bravo.
So they're pegging the claims.
I'm from Greece. My accent a bit funny.
I'm from Alabama. My accent's a bit funny too. I get
too
it.
Much.
Yes.
Two tough guys
in Coober Pedy.
We're approaching the drill now.
Oh, this is the drill.
Uh-huh.
Oh, wow.
Cold world America. It's a bit old, but nice. That's a joke.
Georgie's 70-something years old. He's nimble as a cat. This is crazy.
Okay. Hey, yeah. Good luck.
Good luck.
Maybe you luck.
Oh, wow. I think I get it. So the butterfly only moves down the length of one bucket every time. Oh, it's hydraulically driven. I get it. So this wheel is called the what? This drive wheel.
This one is the ring gear.
So the ring gear drives the butterfly. And these pistons on the side support the weight of the butterfly, which holds the bucket.
Yeah, and it goes lips up and down. That gives you the length.
That's genius. Americans came up with that? That's awesome.
The neat thing about how this drill works is that it's very hands-on. As the bucket comes up to the top, George taught me how to connect one cable so a winch can pull the shaft to the side, and a second rope so you can release a trip mechanism at the bottom of the bucket to dump the material out. You've got to love people like George. He's mastered this art for himself, and even though there's money in it, he's still not stingy with the knowledge that he's gained. For example, in this field, he said that there's two known depths that contain opal, and the locals know exactly how far down it can be found. They remove the material one bucket at a time and constantly measure the hole to see how far from the opal they are. Once the dirt pile changes from brown to white, the depth is confirmed, and then they swarm the pile looking for evidence of opal.
Then you actually go down in the hole and you start looking for opal. That's the interesting part. Let's go do that. the middle of nowhere. Must admit, I'm a little bit scared that we'll fall in a hole.
Nah. If you talk too much, I get upset.
You get upset? I don't believe that.
No, you're my friend. I don't get upset with my friend.
No way.
Opa! All right. That'll do, all right. Yeah, very good.
This, okay, I understand the purpose of the safety rope. It's if your winch doesn't work.
I grab it and I come up.
Yeah, you climb up.
Yes.
Wow. Have you ever had to do that?
Oh, many times, man.
You can still do it?
Then why put the rope for? You are joking.
Oh, man.
If you're not here, I'll be by myself.
No. Let's go.
If I don't come up, that means I stay here all night.
I get it, buddy. Let's roll. Let's roll, man. I get this.
Follow me, please. That's your boy. Thank you. Forward. Your body. Control your body with your toes.
Okay.
All right.
Got it. Wow. Holy cow.
Okay, to review, I met a guy yesterday who took me to a secret hole in the middle of the desert, and now he's lowering me into it on the premise of finding buried treasure. This was approximately the time I realized I should have told any one of these details to my wife.
Holy cow, look at this.
It's opening up.
Oh my gosh. And of course, there's a beer bottle down here.
Okay, so he said unhook this and wave the light. That's what he said.
So I'm gonna wave the light.
You out?
I'm out!
Okay, I go.
Okay.
Once George got to the bottom of the shaft with me, he explained that the drillers ream out the bottom to increase the surface area of the shaft. He then started to legit pick his way through material in different spots based on the color of the dirt. After about 20 minutes of me being really eager to help, but very confused, this happened.
Do you want me to, do you want me to pick for a while?
Yeah, if you want to.
I don't know what I'm doing, but. What?
Come have a look. If you see the color there.
What?
Tell me. If you see some color.
Right here? No, I don't see what you're talking about.
Okay. All
right. Look. Right here?
Yes, but don't.
Are you serious? Yeah. Right there?
Yes.
So that's green?
Yes.
I'm just gonna be straight up with you right now. This is pretty dang crazy. We are in the middle of Australia. How far underground are we?
Not much.
50 feet underground?
Yes.
We went down this hole and we're excited about this little bitty trace in the ground. Man, people are weird. People are weird. We do this so that, I see green right there, by the way.
Where?
Right here, there's green right there. You see it?
Yep. Yeah, champion.
People are so weird. We're doing this because women like pretty things on their ears. What do you think?
Yeah, they're pretty.
This doesn't make any sense at all.
Looks a bit of color there. Can you see color or not?
Oh my gosh.
Eh?
I do see it.
You know what I'm going to do?
What?
I'm going to get a jackpick. You busy?
You're gonna go get a jackpick?
Yeah.
Let's do it. Bring it.
Yeah, no.
Okay, don't leave me here.
You're digging.
I'm digging. Okay, I will dig. And yeah. There are moments in your life where you stop and think about how you got to this point that you are at that moment. This is one of those moments. There's 700 holes that I passed on the way in here. I'm in one of those. The only person that knows which hole I'm in is George, and he just went up that shaft on a rope. This is dumb. There's a big one right here.
Yeah, color.
Yeah,
color.
Color.
Yeah, color.
Color.
You see the color there?
Yeah.
There's that one.
Oh my goodness.
And this one, look. Look.
Man. Look at that. It's an opal. We found an opal.
Yeah, an opal.
George, you're crazy, man.
All this rope here. All right, don't worry, I'm here.
That was awesome. All right, so that is it today here on Smarter Every Day. That is how you go find opals in the middle of this. Yeah. when you see a woman that has opal earrings or an opal pendant or anything, just think of Georgie. Right, Georgie?
Thank you. Especially when the woman is good looking.
If it's a good looking woman, especially think of Georgie.
Okay, this is what raw opal looks like. So George has brought us here to Yanni, who is showing us this stuff.
A stone that was next to that here, I cut it and this came out.
Mm-hmm. Wow.
Expensive opal, by the way.
Right. This is very expensive.
This is before, but I can say, for example, okay, correct me, General. For this one here, maybe 10,000?
50 years mining opal. Anyway, 40 years?
60, 40.
A lot of years. Georgia.
Yes.
Thank you so much.
Thank you, my boy.
I appreciate it. I feel like you're my friend now.
Yeah, I am your friend, man.
Very good.
I am your friend.
Very good. Thank you.
I should be your grandpa, but doesn't matter. I'm your friend.
Anyway, I'm Destin. You're getting smarter every day. Have a good one.
Of course.
Have you ever had your generator die when you're down there?
Many times.
You just climb out the rope.